Hello all, welcome to this course on computer organization. The topics we are looking into today are internal organization of a memory chip and organization of memory unit. Let's start. Memory cells are usually organized in the form of an array in which each cell is capable of storing one bit of information. A possible organization is illustrated in the figure. Each row of the cells constitute a memory word, and all the cells in a row are connected to a common line referred to as the word line, which is driven by the address decoder on the chip. The cells in each column is connected to a sense or write circuit by two bit lines. They are P and B dash. The sense or write circuits are connected to the data input or output lines of the chip. During a read operation, these circuits sense or read the information stored in the cells that are selected by a word line and transmit this information to the output data lines. During a write operation, the sense or write circuits receive input information and store it in the cells of the selected word line. Given is an example of a very small memory chip consisting of 16 words of 8 bits each. This is referred to as 16x8 organization. The data input and data output of each sense or write circuit are connected to a single bidirectional data line that can be connected to the data bus of a computer. Two control lines, R/W and CS, are also provided in addition to address and the data lines. The read or write input specifies the required operation, and the CS control line selects a given chip in the multi-chip memory system. The memory circuit given here stores 128 bits and requires 14 external connections for address, data, and control lines. Of course, it also needs two lines for power supply and ground connection. Now let us consider a slightly large memory circuit, one that has 1K, that is 1024 memory cells. This circuit can be organized as a 128x8 memory, requiring a total of 19 external connections. Alternatively, the same number of cells can be organized into a 1K x1 format. In this case, a 10-bit address is needed, but there is only one data line, resulting in a total of 15 external connections. Given here is such an organization. The required 10-bit address is divided into two groups of 5 bits each to form the row address and the column address of the cell array. A row address selects a row of 32 cells, all of which are accessed in parallel. However, according to the column address, only one of these cells is connected to the external data line by the output multiplexer and the input demultiplexer. Now let us look into the organization of a memory unit. Modern implementations of computer memory are rather complex and difficult to understand on first encounter. To simplify the introduction to the memory structures, we present a traditional architecture here. From the system point of view, we can view the memory unit as a black box. Data transfer between the memory and the processor takes place through the use of two processor registers, usually called MAR or memory address register and MDR or memory data register. If MAR is k bits long and MDR is n bits long, then the memory unit may contain up to 2 raised to k addressable locations. During a memory cycle, n bits of data are transferred between the memory and the processor. This transfer takes place over the processor bus, which has k address lines and n data lines. The bus also includes control lines, that is read or write, and MFC, that is memory function completed, for coordinating data transfers. Other control lines may be added to indicate the number of bytes to be transferred. The connection between the processor and the memory is as given in the figure here. The processor reads data from the memory by loading the address of the required memory location into the MAR register and setting the read or write control signal to 1. The memory responds by placing the data from the addressed location onto the data lines and confirms this action by asserting an MFC signal. Upon receipt of the MFC signal, the processor loads the data onto the data lines and into the MDR register. The processor writes data into a memory location by loading the address of this location to the MAR and loading the data into MDR. It indicates that a write operation is involved by setting the R/W line to 0. If read or write operations involve consecutive address locations in the main memory, then a block transfer operation can be performed in which only the address sent to the memory is the one that identifies the first location. Memory accesses may be synchronized using a clock, or they may be controlled using special signals that control transfer on the bus using the bus signaling schemes. Memory read and write operations are controlled as input and output bus transfers respectively. That's all for now. Thank you. Thank you for listening.